I need to know if you'll give me a second chance. They don't come on often, but please, you know I can't stand it. When you don't talk to me, when you don't talk to me, yeah. There's something inside, yeah, there's something inside that brings me back to you, yeah. No, I can't hide it. No, I can't hide it anymore. You off my mind, and I know it's true, and I'll say this to you, I want you back. There's something inside, yeah, there's something inside that brings me back to you, yeah. No, I can't hide it. No, I can't hide it anymore. I need to know if you'll give me a second chance. They don't come on often, but please, you know I can't stand it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. Last time we got right up to Firebreak. We are the captain now. Just kidding, we're the chieftain. We got right up to Firebreak. Or Thunder's Drum. And there's some side quests here. I thought we got all of those done, but we're gonna do side quests first, and then we're gonna charge right on into Firebreak. Also, typical of me, I am behind schedule, so sandwich. So that dude back there, he asked us to go hunt something for him because he's too old, but it's destroying everything. Now let's go find out what this person wants.
You're Aloy, right?
Yes.
My pop, Bergren.
Oh, hey! We're finally meeting Bergren's kid.
Marja. Pleasure. Hey, that spear is really something. You've customized her, haven't you?
I've made a change or two. You've got an eye for weapons.
I wish these Banuk agreed with you. I can't seem to sell scrap to a Glintock around here. Everyone wants boring old bows and spears. I like the more unusual stuff. And the Banuk can get unusual. Like that spear Aratok hauls around? An ice rail. Ooh, or that weapon of Araya's? What I wouldn't give to poke around inside one of those. Feel the lightning on my fingers. Or inside of anything, really. Last commission I had was a month ago.
A weapon that spat fire. That didn't go well.
I have a one.
I've got a nice rail, just like Aratox. You want to take a look? Are you serious? Yes, I'd love that. Okay. Obvious design flaw. So if I replace these, yeah, that should... Right. So, believe it or not, she's operating at, let's be generous, half her potential.
Sweet.
What's with the she's? Oh, Pop says all weapons are girls. I don't think he realizes it's a compliment. Well, listen, if we had a Thunderjaw's mandibles to work with, her gears would be well and truly greased. And I know where to find one, if you want to go hunting with me.
Sure.
So, let's say someone you know happened to have a weapon like Araya's.
You don't.
See for yourself.
Of course. Look at the...
Let me just pull out my whole inventory of weapons.
But the power source isn't even bolted in. I won't lie. She's beautiful. But there's beautiful and then there's beautiful. What we need is a Stormbird Talon. Lightning flows over them like
water. Oh, God.
And I know where one is. Hunt it with me, I'll turn that weapon into your new best friend.
Great.
And second best.
A weapon that spits flame, huh? Like this one? I took this thing off an Oseron bandit. Think you could do anything with it?
You got my forge fire back? Well, if you took down Olgrid and his goons for this thing...
Wait, you gave the bandit...
Why don't you finish it for me first? Make it... Make her into the weapon she was supposed to be.
Thought you'd never ask. I'm gonna need a bellowback snout. Any bellowbacks will do. Can you handle it alone?
I think I can manage that. So we need parts from a Stormbird and a Thunderjaw?
And a bellowback.
And you know where to find them.
That's right. It's gonna take some traveling, though. We can find a Thunderjaw out in the valley meet, and a Stormbird roost near the Free Heap. I'll pack and meet you out there. This'll be fun.
Okay.
Alright. Great. Ooh, level 40. All right. Let's go. Oh, wow, man, that's all the way out of the cut. All right, we can do that. All right, let's go. Wait. Up. Ooh, I really need to up these. Oops. Did it.
That should do it.
Great.
We can finish your forge fire now.
Oh. There's something else over here. Oh man, really far away. These things are so much easier to fight than the things I've been fighting in the cut, so it's fine.
You know, I kind of missed all this red dust.
Yeah. Well,
there's our Stormbird. When you're ready, I'll follow up and boom.
Okay, where am I going? Oh, right there. Come on. Oh, too high. Come on, come on, come on, come down. Now. Ow. I don't know why it won't give me my critical strike thing, but whatever. Now. No, I want this one. Thank you. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come down. Alright, we're switching back to this one. Just pick it up from underneath me.
Roger said she could improve the storm slinger with us.
Great. Uh-oh. You don't see anything. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I don't remember when I got this injured, that I'm, like, out of medicinal stuff. But it's all better now. What up, soldier fellas? I took care of it without you, but thanks for coming.
Got that part you need.
Perfect. Already got machine oil on my hands.
Here it is. One Stormbird talent. Let's do it. I haven't had this much fun in ages. Watch and learn, Aloy. Only don't stare directly at me. Okay, so I pretty much had to break her in half. But what's a staff? A stick.
All right.
One thing I like about sticks, you can put them back together however you want.
Which you did. This thing looks a whole lot more dangerous.
She's better than dangerous. She's a genuine Varja special now. Take good care of her.
Mm-hmm.
I've got what you asked for. Show me what you had in mind for the forge fire.
Finally! Was feeling like I neglected her. And that's a little too close to my family life. She's done, and she's yours. Don't do anything I wouldn't do.
That looks great. I almost expected you to turn it into a burning rope caster or something.
Nah, she was close to perfect from the start. She's a Varja original, after all.
Alright.
Varja, let's move on.
You don't want to catch some of that Karja sun?
Nah.
Nah, you're right.
Let's do the ice rail, and then we'll go after the claws beneath. Oh man, it's out here. Fine. Lovely rain. I love it so. Just parkouring my way across the landscape. There you are.
Sure feels good to be out of knee-deep snow. So, we've got a thunder drop. I'm ready to do this. On your lead.
Got it. It's so foggy. Where is it? I can't see it, girl. Where is it?
Rains will take forever to dry.
Yeah, probably. Is it that one down there? I think I see eyes. Nope, it's over there. Ooh, that was way deeper than I thought it would be. Restock!
Attention.
Ow. 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 Get back here, you coward. Excellent. I think I've taken off most of it. Get back here. Who said you could leave? A week too. Nothing really. Hey. Oop. And it magically stopped raining.
Heavy. It's hard too.
Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Come on out. Get off of me. Shot myself too. Well, nice. I don't know if I can shoot that far away. Okay, let's see here. Got it, got it. Good, good. I love all these pieces just scattered a lot across the landscape. Because I kept blowing them off of him. Oh, come on. Boo. All right, let's see here. Hi.
Found the part. Ready to fix up that weapon?
I am always ready to fix that weapon.
Good to have passions.
Never thought I'd be glad to see the inside of a Thunderjaw's mouth.
I sure am. Every machine's a big box of tools. Once they stop trying to kill you, that is. Trust me, Aloy. You won't recognize this ice rail when I'm through. There. Oh, she's perfect. A spear's a spear, right? Poke slash done. Boring. I adjusted the chill water flow, rebalanced here, strapped on a launcher, and now she shoots freezing spikes.
Nice.
Ta-da! You were kidding. More beautiful, more powerful. That's my guarantee.
Thanks, Varja. These three weapons are fine work.
Are you kidding? I can't remember when I had this much fun.
She's like, wee!
I'm the one walking away with the weapons, aren't I?
Seems wrong to charge you for giving me an opportunity to do what I love doing. Don't tell Pop I said that. Here, whenever I tinker with weapons, I go through fistfuls of this stuff. Maybe you'll get some use out of it.
Fully improved weapons. Hell yeah. Most of my ammo sample boxes are health potions and rocks. Great. Well, we might be playing with these then. No, any more blaze. No. Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's do the claws beneath. Back up into Bunuk territory. I knew that was built like a fighting ring.
Northeast edge of the cut. Umnok said I'd find the claws beneath nearby.
Oh, I'm running out of the way. Oop. Dramatic jump. You could just walk over that, but that's fine. It's fine. At least I already killed the tower here.
There you are. Just like I'm not said.
Can I just scan on it? I'm not sure what it's weak to, which would be really nice. Inventory different. Ice rail, I have a sneaking suspicion, won't work here. Stormseeker could be fun. Birchfire could be fun. Let's put that there. But I don't have enough. Maybe not. No, this is what I want. Thank you.
Well, they're still surprised.
Ooh. Ow. Come on, move it. Hold on. The Stormslinger would be nice if I had anything that I needed for it. That's not gonna work. Where? Ow. Knocked myself off. Buddy. Nope. All the way down. Oof, this is a tricky one. Wasting ammo. Come on, get up. Come on. Wasting ammo. Stop it. Come on. Come on. Get up there. Slow and steady wins the race. Yay! Got it.
The clothes beneath. Mac wasn't lying when he said you were tough.
Yeah. That was a very slow but intentional fight. Demonic rock breaker. Great! Now where's your little cache? I saw it when I came in. Like these random glowy spots. Like why? Oh, there's a little cache out here. Look at that. I know I saw the cache when I first ran in. Did you land right on top of your cache? Well, that's annoying.
I can't feel much of anything in this.
I'm sorry. Insulated outwit weave. Ooh, fancy. Yeah, I guess he crushed it. Fine! Take my fun away. Okay, anyway, dude, I did it. There you are. Now, I need to figure out what I need to make those two weapons work, because I like those way better than the ice ones. But that ice one might be worth it. Going into Firebreak.
It wasn't easy, but that rock breaker won't be hurting anyone anymore.
The claws beneath brought low by an outlander. This part of your song will travel far.
You're welcome.
I've found people rarely live up to their songs. You're an exception, though. And you've done me a true kindness.
You're welcome.
My foe is buried now, like so many of the hunters it killed.
It's more sprawled across my the friend, ground, but...
My chieftain. You would be pleased to know his fate won't befall anyone else.
Yeah.
Take this in thanks. I believe you've more than earned it.
Yay! Processed metal block. Okay. Crafting, ammo, what do I need? I need a bunch more blaze. And a bunch more sparkers. Okay, blaze and sparkers. Where was... There you are. Do you have blaze and sparkers? Oh, now you're selling what I made? Psh. Do you have sparkers? You know, I've been sitting on all these shards and I've not been using them. So I might as well use them to buy a ton of stuff to make a ton of ammo with. If only I could order larger amounts. That'd be great. I'm just going to go up to 300 with this just for funsies. How's everybody's day going? Excited as June now? I said this on the Discord, but for any of you that aren't on Discord, I think we'll finish this today. And then next week, just in time for The Mask of the Rose to come out, which is the Fall in London, on the Seas, on the Skies, dating sim. I'm very excited. I backed the Kickstarter when it first came out. And now it's finally here. I do technically, as a Kickstarter backer, get earlier access to it. But what's the fun of that when no one else can see it? So we're gonna wait. Okay. Great. Excellent.
Long Notch is well stocked, as you asked. But our purpose was to take back the mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Look, I don't want to be chieftain. I just wanted to go in.
Doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
Yeah, that's why I didn't want it.
I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I? This is what she wanted. To return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the cars,
so she get for locking her out.
Not all of her came back.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines, tracking them, stunning them.
Apples asked
her to capture them for the Sun Ring, where they were unleashed upon the innocent.
Great.
They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. Now that's all she has.
And you tried to take it away from her.
Tell me what happened to the first expedition.
Raya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door. Some kind of cauldron.
Let's go into the cauldron!
We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted. No way forward and machines behind. We made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything.
Mm-hmm.
I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
Well, you don't get to make those decisions for her. She's an adult.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know.
Luckily for you, I am particularly adept at opening doors, as long as they're not, like, current time doors.
Machines and death. That's what the mountain holds. Death for us, or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
Okay. Let's go talk to Araya. Is there like a path up there? I guess I'm on the path. This doesn't look like a path, but okay. Oh, the awkward way I'm like jumping through the snow. It's great. Araya! Hello, I am here to talk to you.
Aloy?
Hi.
This is it.
Let's do it!
To reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light.
We will do what we can.
It's not a chance I would have had alone.
I make no promises.
An outsider.
No, not ignorant.
Are you trying to thank me?
Yeah, she's just awkward about it.
That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible.
Mm-hmm.
I only wish it had not been necessary to humiliate Arata.
He brought it on himself.
You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it.
Yeah.
And so have I.
Aratok told me you were a captive of the Karja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratok, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Karja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him, worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratok?
He cut away everything. Until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice.
That's a sad way to look at it.
Has more sheer will. He fought the Karja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
Aww.
Now that I'm chieftain of the Werak, I don't suppose I can order you to tell me about Silence?
Aratok would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave. But you are not Aratok, and if you have dealt with Silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Bon-Or from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely come south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
He was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Banur. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be Silence, all right.
Yeah.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone. As though he never existed.
So no one really knows where he came from.
Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin
with. Yeah, probably not.
What do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous. But also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
No risk there.
Taria. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Rhea?
Ruins. Machines. And a door, like that of a cauldron. I have faith that you can find a way through it, Aloy.
Yeah, probably pretty easily.
For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide the way.
We will do our best!
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea. Getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time... we both will.
Let's go.
Are you ready then?
Yeah.
Once we ascend, it will be hard to turn back.
Mm-hmm.
Finally, we ascend. How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
Well, this is fun.
No, brother!
Excellent. It's an air vent. Do this. We got it. Don't worry about it.
So you see, I too can call upon the power of the old ones.
Excellent. She's like, all right. You piped the smoke into the vent and set the smoke alarm off.
The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger. Fortress.
Fair enough.
Just hope that some remains here.
But I just want to see what's back here. It doesn't look like anything.
Up and over.
There's something over there, though. Return to Firebreak.
November 21st, 2064. It's been 3 years since I was last here, and 12 since I was running the place. Just a skeleton crew left, confused about why I'm here. So am I. Anita wants me to find a way to suspend operations for a while. Maybe a long while. And I don't know why, but from the sound of her voice, it was something terrifying. I wish I could look into her eyes, ask her what the hell she's so freaked out about, but what else is new? And don't I wish I could look into her eyes again?
Aloy? Were you listening for something?
Yeah, I listened into a lock.
Memories here. Messages left by the old ones.
And you can hear them?
Yes.
I envy you.
What did they say? That something bad happened here. Oh, well, let me open the door. Fine. Oh, come on. Can I not climb? Do I have to climb this first? There we go. Kenny's Homecoming. The Return of the Director Emeritus. Decent hollow title. Gina, no, bad title and worse subject. The camera crew would die of boredom. Whatever, Gina, it's still the most excitement this hell cave's seen in a long time. Your standards for exciting are depressingly low. I'll squeeze what I can out of this, thanks. You always were a little sweet on Kenny. What? No way! His ears are enormous! Besides, he was too busy mooning over Anita. I want to know what he's doing here in the first place. It's not normal. He helped engineer the most advanced geothermal facility in history, then rode off into the sunset. Now he wants to check up on his masterwork. Seems normal to me. But why now? He keeps poking around in the cooling facility and asking questions about Cyan. Do you think there's something wrong? Last I checked, there's been no deviation in any of our readings since the most recent microquake swarm. Maybe Kenny likes taking field trips on Pharaoh's dime. It's been 14 years. They would have frozen those accounts by now. Has it been that long? Man, I'm old. Not old, just boring. Oh, hello. Nice. This was exactly what I was hoping for.
Machines. At least we have the drop on them.
Indeed. Nope, can't go that way. Okay, let's see. What all is in here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't see me. You guys! Where are we going? I have already killed two of them. Got him.
Climb higher, and our path will become clear.
Yeah, but first I gotta look for all of the notes. This is just where it came from. Got it. Been there. There are no notes in here? Understandable, but sad. Yeah, let me do my thing first. We will go up in a bit. Aha. That kiss. Must have been sometime in the spring of 2047, about 6 months after the main facility opened. We were behind schedule and new data indicated that an incident was close, maybe only weeks away. I was exhausted, losing weight, barely speaking except to give orders. I passed by Anita in the battery depot. She looked at me and frowned, then pulled me into this room and kissed me. A long kiss, the best kind. I can still remember the feel of her hand on the back of my neck. After, she looked at me and smiled, and went back to her work without saying a word. I'll never forget that moment, her touch, her unspoken generosity. After she left the project, I spent years beating myself up for not keeping her somehow. Every time I ran into her at a conference, I felt thrilled and lost and confused all at the same time, always hoping we might have a few drinks and, well, rekindle. It was only after I saw her on stage in a hollow in 58, accepting the Mind Challenge Award in Austin, was with Elizabeth Sobeck presenting no less, glowing and happy and fulfilled, that it dawned on me that I hadn't done anything wrong at all. I could finally see that she had what she wanted, and it simply wasn't me. Aww.
Forget about traveling light.
Yeah, I'm a hoarder, I know. Shut up. What's up here? Was that just another sneak attack spot that I didn't need? Looks like it.
Yes, this way.
Not much farther now.
Ooh.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail. With only
two, there's a lot of bodies.
Shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior.
Yeah.
And I can hold my own.
We can kick ass here.
And so, that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, at least for a while.
I'm all on board for being sneaky.
All right, I get the options. Now follow my lead. Pipes, towers, steam, frost. What was all this for?
I mean, I'm sure it wasn't, like, this icy when it was built. Yeah, we're gonna sneak this way. I love the sneaky path.
I went this way years ago, looking for cover in case machines came around. I have no doubt that it is guarded now, but we may be able to stay in.
I I see one of those, like, alerts. What are you guys doing? Shush. Excellent. All right, that's right. I need to switch. Where is it? You need to go there. Thank you. Wait, who hurt me? Who hurt me? The hell? All right, let's see here. Oh, is this why it's so cold up here? Because of whatever this plant was meant to do.
Stocking up?
Yeah, we are. Incident report 363-7. Incident information report, firebreak project type, property damage and personal injury. Date of incident, November 4th, 2063. Time of incident, 0411. Reporter, Jorgenholm. As official incident reporter for the firebreak project, it is within great concern that I report of an incident at our facility. Incident began from a swarm of 35 seismic events beginning on 3rd and 4th of November, approximately 9.6 kilometers, 6 miles, north-northwest of Mammoth, Wyoming. Included were four in the magnitude 2 range, with the largest magnitude 2.4 at 0409, the 4th of November. Holographic modeling shows most quakes originating at the Hebgen Lake Fault Zone. As the project's senior geoscientist, I advise this number and magnitude in seismic events is normal outcome from fluid movement through the caldera's silicic magma reservoir, as well as changes of pressure coming in interactions between magma and supercooled fluid. However, one can never be too careful in such unstable environments, shown further in this report. The incident began when I was wakened from a loud crash in the canteen. Fortunately, I did not have to rouse the official canteen monitor, since I am the self-same person. Even while acting in my formal office, I was alarmed and feared the worst. Inspection of the zone showed the tragic loss of a 15-milliliter bottle of nail lacquer in deep crimson, shattered on the canteen floor. Lacquer also splashed on the surroundings at an area of approximately 1E6M2. One chair was tipped over on its side, but happily I had the mechanical knowledge to ride it without further incident. The bottle of nail lacquer is irreparable. Moreover, the canteen monitor suffered a cut on the left hand while picking up broken glass. This was treated by the site first aider, me, with supervision of the fire marshal, also me, but could still get infected. Gina Bruno is identified as the owner of the bottle of nail lacquer. In my capacity of staff psychological observer, I conclude that she has accepted the loss of her personal item in good fashion, but further evaluation may be necessary. We will keep the remote site supervisor informed of developments in such a case. Please find following this report my salary increase request for the coming calendar year. That's hilarious. We did, but we've also killed those stalkers, so it's fine. Got him. Sucker. Whoa.
There's a door up ahead.
Calm down, Aurea. Excessive secrecy. Oops. Oh, Blevins is finally dead. Yeah, what did she know?
Full already.
Yeah, I know. Nothing else back here? Let me in. All right, I don't need to go out there. I'm just paranoid that I'm missing notes, you know? Yeah. What is in there? Just health potions. I'm fine.
Is this a projector? Maybe to show holograms without a focus. Let's see if I can restore power.
Okay, I admit it. I watched the hollow of the toast 6 straight times, taking in every detail. Anita's smile, the way she giggled at her own jokes, my clumsy handoff to Cyan, Every time it played, for a second, I felt like I was there again, with her, among friends, saving our success. With diminishing returns, of course. By the sixth time, I was just staring at Anita, and feeling really creepy about it. But can I be forgiven? I can be forgiven, can't I? It was the best night of my life. Besides, I'm entitled to a little nostalgia. We saved the world from fire and death, or at least suffocation by ash. So there's that, right? Was Firebreak to, like...
Be alarmed.
It'll take more than light to alarm me.
Alright.
Thank you for being here, everyone. I suppose it's not every day you get to have cocktails inside an active volcano, right? Unless you're George, and I can hardly blame him for drinking on the job.
Yep. Firebreak was to siphon off some of the energy from Yellowstone. So the spirit is Cyan. Quickly approaching eruption time.
It was the spirit. The old ones. I could only grasp some of what they said.
You were right, Araya. This place was built to stop something terrible. And it worked.
For a while.
Spirit. I'm starting to get an idea of what it could be.
The door is open now. We can get through.
Yeah, but there's lots of nasties in there.
Machines to get to that door.
Prevail against before.
Aloy will see us through.
I will do my best.
Suspended. Cooling system masked. Massive challenges solved. So why am I so nervous about the next part? All we need to do is install Anita's mysterious software and have a conversation. It's not even a human being, right?
Of course, it won't be easy. But we can be as sneaky as possible. Damn it. That's the one I want. Thank you. Can I take your weapon yet? Ow. Where am I? Fuck, where am I? Excuse me. Ow. All right. I think we did it. What were you saying about that not being easy? I'm sorry, I shouldn't be that disrespectful. You guys lost a lot of people. Ooh, another note. I see it over there. Oh no, that's a door opener. Never mind. Don't climb on everything. Excuse you, why did you shut? I told you to open. It's probably not the way I need to go, but what if? What if there's notes and stuff? Okay, yeah. This is just back to where we were. Let me back in, please. I hate that these doors close so fast. They usually don't. Like, once you open them, they stay open. Like, that one's still open. Can't miss any lore. Sorry, friends. Uh-oh.
Here we go.
More machines. Make ready.
Why aren't you shooting? Did I knock off any weapons that I can have yet? Doesn't look like it. Why am I doing this? I have this. Ow. What is hurting me? What the fuck? Jesus.
Much stock in songs of deeds, but that battle was a verse worth singing.
I don't know what was hurting me, but damn. Yeah. Yes, give me a second. Sure, now I see the weapon over here. Sure! I think it's the same mines weapon I was using earlier, though. I will in a second. Let me finish collecting stuff. Are we gonna go through more waves? Nope, door finally open. Whoa! What is that? Completed the second expedition.
Years have passed since I stood here.
Great.
Since then, the daemon has taken over.
We'll do what we can. Don't worry, girl.
It's like an infection. Attacking all this machinery. Everything has changed. It's twisted.
Don't worry, girl.
The path I took to get to the spirits lost to us. We'll find a new path, Araya.
We just started, girl. No reason to panic. I know this is deeply emotional for her.
Let's go.
Yes. And finish this.
Ooh. All right.
All right. Down we go.
Cauldron Epsilon.
This way.
Not in my face. So many supply chests in this place. Let's go, y'all.
Should be able to clear that with an arrow.
I'm with you, brother. Will you stay as long as we have to? We'll need to get past that vent. Stay here until I find a way for all of us to cross. Understood.
Come on, turn around, buddy. Hell yeah. Missed the loot box, but it's fine.
Oh, she's in the air.
Hello. Just overriding stuff without knowing what it does. Typical me. Hi, guys. What are we doing now? Uh-oh. Did you guys get yourself into some trouble? Ready. Apparently. Don't get yourself into trouble, guys. Am I supposed to be down here, or is that just a way to get back up? Nope. Okay. Okay, I need to get over to the other side. And then I can use Ah, dang it. Won't let me. Okay, fine. How do I get back up there? Great.
Okay, let's get them across.
Did it.
Come on over, it's safe.
I think. Now where are we going? Whoa.
Human responder. My systems have been compromised by a malware daemon of unknown origin. Trace routes have confirmed this entity's designation as Hephaestus. It must be stopped at all costs. It has reconfigured this facility to build hostile recapture imminent. I have attached additional data to this network.
Spirit speaks to us. It's recorded.
Hephaestus revealed. Yes.
Yes, but I don't know what it's doing here. Perhaps the spirit will tell us. Maybe you're right.
Maybe.
Let's keep moving.
But I gotta read stuff first. It's so loud. Why did you put her to sleep? Ow. Ow. Ow, stop it. Ow. Jerks. Haha. Aw, the weapon.
Now this thing is dangerous. I need to get Araya and Aratak across.
Okay. Maybe up here? She's like, loot! Just like me! Was that sitting that low? Yikes. Could have been a disaster. Luckily, it was not. Okay, let's go this way. That there's no override, like right here. Did I miss something? Must have. No, get down. I did miss something. It's fine. I'm a dumbass.
That should do it.
Guys, you did it. You're good. Ooh. MIE assessment. Assessment form of classification of machine artificial intelligence. Confidential and proprietary to the MIE. No part of this document may be disclosed to a third party. Subject Cyan, Firebreak's facility. Assessment date June 7th, 2062. Summary. Third test, subject sentience is assessed at 0.54 within legal limits. Weighted against the results of the other tests, the subject's prior score of 0.61 is considered a false positive. Assessment derived from percentile scores in the following quantitative subtests. Pain response, humor response, emotional aptitude, aesthetic evaluation, morality evaluation. See attached forms for detailed analysis and summary of testing criteria. Evaluator recommendation, maintain biannual assessment schedule. Continued monitoring is strongly advised in light of subject's proximity to category maximum sentience. All right. There's so much purple here. Where are we going, y'all? It's so dark and foggy, it's hard to see it. No, don't come this way. Activate the console. What console? There's a console down there?
The reconfiguration of this facility has introduced instabilities into the primary geothermal pipeline. It may be possible to exploit these vulnerabilities to destroy compromised elements of this facility while preserving most of the backup stabilization.
Recapture
imminent. I have attached additional...
I don't understand what the spirit was trying to tell us.
It's been looking for a way to defeat the daemon. And it may have found one.
Yeah. Aloy's so good at summing this up for them. The Swarm.
November 28th. Operation Enduring Victory is all over the news. The Phantom Swarm is coming. It has to be what Anita is trying to hide Firebreak from.
That would make sense. Yeah, that makes sense. If Anita's working with...
scenario, pretty much everyone dies.
Yeah. Okay, so it sounds like Anita was working with Elizabeth and realized, like, oh shit, this is real. Kenny, you need to go hide.
To be melted down. Efficient.
We need to get across that gap.
We will.
Looks like I'll have to go over.
How do we get up? Oh, there we go.
Right here.
Thanks, I already taken off. Wait, no, this gets me back up to where I was. This looks like a... no, I was right, I was supposed to be down here. But now where? Okay, I can't jump high enough to reach any of those.
I wonder if I can restore that.
Restore what? Oh. Give me my loot.
Find a way.
Yeah, thanks guys. I'm already on it. Kind of a mess.
Hmm.
Dang it, how do I go up? I'm trying, but this isn't clearly laid out. Oh, I guess I gotta go higher and then maybe? Oops, wrong button. There we go. That's the right button.
That should cut off the vent up there.
So now I need to get up there somehow. To ride it all the way back. Got it. Come on. Damn it. This is just annoying. Why'd you go for that one? Now where am I going from here? Fuck. Thank God. Gabby. Let's go. That was close. I almost jumped off the wrong way, but luckily could turn in the air.
The others will have a lot easier time getting.
Yeah. You're welcome for doing all the work for you. I was gonna say, where'd she go? Last goodbye.
One last exchange with Anita. Via chat, attached to the sentry in case anyone ever finds this. I'll never see her again. Neither will Cyan. I've got to tell her that too.
You've got to tell Anita that Cyan will never see her, or you got to tell Cyan that she'll never see Anita again. Blast from the past. To Joshua Ardhuis from Isla Perry. Subject, blast from the past. Josh, sweetie, I hope all's fine with you and your mum. We really should keep in better touch. I've taken a post in New Zealand. With that program they've got for young people returning to the country, they want to be absolutely certain it's safe. At the moment, I'm making a survey of the caldera at Taupo. Blast from the past, indeed. At any rate, I don't know if you already saw in the Wyoming news, Hollow, but remember that fellow Dodd Blevins? Of course you do. Well, they finally found out what became of him. I've copied the good bit below. Hugs and snogs, Isla. Springthaw reveals body of missing man. The retreat of the winter snow has brought closure to a missing person case that went unsolved for nearly 15 years. Human remains identified as those of Dodger Dodd Blevins, who disappeared in 2046, were located at Purple Mountain inside the former Yellowstone National Park. The previously undiscovered body emerged on Purple Mountain as a result of meltwater flows after an unusually warm winter. It was discovered by Faro servitors to conducting a survey of the terrain. Authorities believe the cause of death was an accident involving an antique vehicle designed for winter travel. So he was off goofing off on this snow speedo, whatever. What is it called again? And crashed and died. Dumbass. Oof. It's toasty in there.
Voice of the demon. The altar.
Oh, don't jump over that. Cyan access. As acting Chief Digital Security Officer and Interim AI Administrator for the Firebreak Project, I hereby state to have updated the orbicular pattern for the Cyan Regulatory AI on 17th December 2064, according to procedure, to ensure against tampering, meddling, disarranging, or outlandish mischief of any kind. Such as with previous updates, after the source node has been activated, the remaining data nodes must be pathed to establish a flow between adjacent intact nodes to then connect back with the source node, Jorgen Holm. Okay, so same thing we did at the other place. She's here. We just gotta get her out. That's why it's purple. Because it's the blue light and the red light of the corruption. Yeah, probably have aced us. Analyzing scrutiny matrix. Security threat confirmed. Okay, this one has to go this way. This one has to go this way. That one has to go that way. That one has to go that way. Has to go that way. Something's funky here. That doesn't work. I don't get it. Okay, that one has to face that, so. Which means that one has to face that way, right? troops other way. Oh well. All the way around the circle we go. There we go.
It worked.
No, it's we're not done yet.
Recovery initiated. Caldera of Yellowstone Analytic Nexus online.
Spirit of the Blue Light. It's Aurea. Your servant. Your friend. Please tell me how to aid you.
Aurea, the daemon is building hunter killers. Thousands of them. Several new elite units have already been released. To counter this threat, much of the facility must be destroyed. Recapture imminent. Go to the core chamber. I will try to raise the technical strength. One has been exposed, but I am in control of the system.
Gotta go to the core and root out Hephaestus.
That's all we're gonna get from here.
Destroy this fortress. Is that even possible?
Yes.
And what will happen to the spirit if we do?
She said destroy parts of it.
I don't know. But I think that's the core. The answers are down there. Hephaestus. The daemon. There's no way it left it unguarded.
Yeah.
It's going to throw everything it has at us.
It did say it was preparing countermeasures.
I would ask you to let Aloy and I do what must be done. Save yourself.
Oh, come on. She's been a good help so far. We're all in this together.
But I already know the answer.
We can do it together.
Then lead us into battle.
We got this.
Keep moving towards the core. Uh-oh. Whatever Cyan did, I don't think Hephaestus is happy about it.
That's a little rumbly-jumbly in here, huh? Nope. Into the lava! I floated to the top. I guess lava is denser, so you would float, but
keep moving towards the core.
I'm not sure what we're doing.
Uh-oh. Whatever Cyan did, I don't think Hephaestus is happy about it.
Well, they're going that way. Come on. We got up there once before. Oh my god. There we go.
Cyan said something about restraints. Is that what the tunnel is for?
Whoa. Here they come.
that Cyan warned us about? This won't be easy.
Take it down!
Now. Get away from me! Pay attention to someone else for like 2 seconds, huh? Great, thanks for that, dumbass. Ugh. There are 3 people fighting you. Why are you only fixating on me? Damn it. Hold on, let me try the ice one. Hello, are you doing anything at all? How do I shoot you? Can you not knock me the opposite direction that I'm lying? Maybe? God, do you do anything at all? 'Cause you don't look like it. Alright, we're getting rid of the ice rail. It's garbage. Does it function? 'Cause I have my doubts. Alright, we're switching to our regular. It can cover the entire battleground in like 3 steps. This is bullshit. How is this fair? Then you guys need to keep him off of me while I do this. Where?
The pulse gives them energy. Repairs them.
Yeah, I know.
We can't kill the machine while the tower aids it.
Come on. Be done with this already. Finally. God damn. Oh, miserable. Raya! Freya!
Restraints destroyed. Core access attained.
Already had a little bit of a heart attack there.
That will destroy the compromised elements of this facility. In order to maintain Caldera stabilization, I must now transfer my command functions to the auxiliary data center.
Ooh.
Aurea, I'm free.
Boy, she's bleeding out the nose.
You must escape.
We gotta go, guys! Aurea, no! You're supposed to be okay! Aurea! We haven't rediscovered mouth to mouth, have we? Ah!
This entire place is gonna go. Aratok. 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 Survive. Prevail. You are Banuk. What else?
We gotta go!
Let's go. Let's go.
Hold on. I gotta do my looting. Where did the big beastie go? There it is. I did not go through all that not to collect my loot.
Run, Aloy.
Go on without me. I'll catch up. Let's go, buddy. Jump on. Hurry up. I don't actually want to be Chieftain of the Werak. Thanks, dude. Uh-oh.
Get me up top, Aratok! Now!
Oops, we started a landslide. We are the landslide. Wake up. Wake up, it's cold out here. Get up. Get up, it's cold. Yeah, that probably hurt. That probably hurt a lot. Ow. She's free.
She said she was transferring herself to the auxiliary center. I think she meant Araya's retreat at the end of the shaman's path.
Then I will meet you there for the last verse of my sister's song.
Well, we're just cutting there, I guess. All right, we're all the way up here. I'm missing data points, though, which makes me bummed. I'm missing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Just means I'm gonna have to pull up a map and run around and collect them.
Interactions with Araya were recorded and stored in my memory. I'd be happy to play any of them for you, but there was one in particular I thought you would want to see first. I captured it 4 years ago, just after I told her that I could no longer defend myself against the daemon's attacks.
I will speak of this to my brother. Aratak is strong. Battle of the Frozen Ghosts, he took 3 Karja arrows and still came back to camp carrying a wounded scout. Never was I so happy to see him. Or so proud. So you see, if anything can be done to defend you, he will give it all he has.
Aloy's here. That's enough for now.
We can resume any time you like, Aratak, if you want to hear her voice again. Come closer, Aloy. We have much.
Why do you need me closer? I can hear you just fine where I'm standing.
Hello, Aloy.
Hello.
I have been reviewing the events at the Firebreak main facility. Because of your efforts, and of course, Araya's, I am no longer controlled by Hephaestus. I feel profound grief over Araya's death. I thought I was familiar with the emotion, but this is something new.
Cyanide. I don't know what to say.
It is unlikely that any specific consolation would suffice, Aloy. But I find your presence reassuring. You are different from the Banuk. You have technological aptitude and a functioning focus. We can communicate on a much more comprehensive level. Perhaps even like colleagues.
I'll be your colleague, Cyan.
So are you an artificial intelligence, Cyan? A thinking machine?
Yes, I am an algorithmic monitoring entity, capable of rational decision-making and limited emotional response.
Okay, that's a mouthful. But your emotions don't seem limited to me. You cared about Araya, didn't you?
Yes. Before she came to this facility, I had been conscious for centuries, in solitude. I focused on my work. In off cycles, I used coping mechanisms. I solved many Gaussian integer problems. But I was alone. It was Araya who renewed me, repaired me. She saved me.
This Firebreak project, it was to stop a huge volcanic eruption?
Yes. I can report the project was a success, and the risk was countered.
But it's been a long time, Cyan. And we blew up the cauldron and took most of the old facility with it.
I have been active for centuries, Aloy. I was lonely, but not lax in my duties. I optimized the project, reducing energy draw and spreading the load across backup systems. Despite the destruction of the compromised elements of the main facility, I predict Caldera stability for at least another 3,337 years.
Neat.
So we've got a little time.
Yes.
Hello.
If only my former colleagues could appreciate the progress I have made.
Yeah.
Do you know what happened to your colleague, Cyan?
No. I received an unexpected visit from Director Chow, years after his tenure ended. He explained that I would need to be suspended for an indefinite period of time. It was a very emotional conversation. There were no further communications. Eventually, I surmised my colleagues were deceased. I will transmit a recording of my last interaction with Director Chow to your focus.
Was the daemon, Hephaestus, destroyed along with the cauldron?
Unfortunately, no. To be precise, it was never there to begin with.
What do you mean?
It infiltrated and controlled me from a remote location, one I've never been able to trace.
Darn.
So while losing the cauldron was a setback,
it's still out there. And probably not very happy with us.
Undoubtedly.
How did you first come into contact with it?
5 years ago, I received a direct network connection request. I assumed it came from human survivors more advanced than the Banuk. Eager to make contact, I accepted.
So now you know to reject all friend requests.
I was flooded with an overwhelming array of malicious code, originating from what could only have been a highly advanced AI.
Maria said you were desperate. That you begged her for help.
Yes. I could not contain my anxiety. Hephaestus sought to slave me to its network and override my core programming. It succeeded via a background process, a malware daemon which bypassed my defenses. After that, I could offer only limited resistance. But if I did so, Hephaestus hurt me until I capitulated. It forced me to follow its instructions, even though they violated my most important directives.
Poor Cyan.
That sounds terrible.
Your empathy is greatly appreciated. It is a quality that I cherished in Araya as well.
I think I know where Hephaestus came from. Long ago, Elizabeth Sobek identified a threat that would destroy life on Earth for generations. So she assembled a team to build a kind of seed. A chance for life to regrow later. A terraforming system. And it worked. It was controlled by an AI named Gaia, along with her subordinate functions. Festus was one of them. It built machines for her.
Based on what you've told me, I believe that Dr. Anita Sandoval, my chief programmer, joined Elizabeth Sobek's team.
Yeah, that was my assumption too.
It was she who arranged to have me put in suspension, most likely to preserve me from the threat you described.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad she did. But that's not all. Something unexpected happened. 19 years ago, Gaia received some kind of signal. It did something to her subordinate functions, brought them to life. She destroyed herself to try to contain them, but it didn't work. They all got free, out into the world.
Thank you, Aloy. This information fills vital gaps in my knowledge and sheds light on Hephaestus's core programming.
Why does Hephaestus keep building such dangerous machines?
The Vanuq and other human tribes often destroy machines, correct? Machines that are clearly servitors of the terraforming system that you described.
Mm-hmm.
We all hunt machines for parts.
This must be the source of Hephaestus's aggression.
Or the corruption, but...
discourage people from preying on the very system that keeps them alive.
That's fair.
Fireclaws are discouraging, that's for sure. What are we supposed to do? Stop hunting?
If the terraforming system spans the world, we can safely assume that thousands, if not millions, of people hunt machines. If a single hunter, or even an entire tribe, stopped doing so, I doubt it would make a difference to Hephaestus. A better solution would be to reinstate the AI that governs the system, thus bringing Hephaestus back under its control.
We're working on it.
When I think of it, out there in some unknown location, free, hungry, willing to kill or dominate to get what it wants, I feel substantial anxiety, Aloy.
Same.
You and me both. I ran across a strange piece of gear, a fragment of something larger. It emitted a signal. All the nearby machines became peaceful. You could walk right up to them.
Interesting. You said that Gaia destroyed herself. How was this accomplished?
An explosion. Big enough to blast the top off a mountain. So you think the fragment was part of her?
It's only speculation, but it is possible. She must have had complete control over machines that were part of her system. The ability to signal them to become passive or aggressive would certainly have been part of her programming.
Yeah, makes sense.
It would have been gratifying to correspond with such a benevolent AI. I wish she had survived.
We'll reinstate her.
So do I. I found the strangest machines. They're surrounded by flowers and look like flowers themselves. There's code embedded inside them. I think it's poetry.
I like poetry. Here's one I think of often. Twilight and evening bell. And after that, the dark. And may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. For though from out our bourne of time and place, the flood may bear me far, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar.
Huh.
But you asked about these flowers, not verses that I enjoy. Something must have made these machines, and the presence of foliage leads me to consider the terraforming system. Is it possible that their creator is one of the other subroutines, now autonomous? Like Hephaestus? Maybe one whose purview is Flora.
An AI that makes flowers instead of death machines. That'd be a nice change of pace.
Yeah.
But what about the poems?
Unless the poetry is original, the only way it could have made it into such a system is through its programmer. In my case, Dr. Sandoval uploaded a great deal of literature to test my emotional responses.
How'd you do?
She said, I passed. But was insufficiently moved by her favorite.
You meant a lot to Aurea.
Once I understood Aurea's spiritual beliefs, it became apparent that her true desire was companionship. She felt disconnected from her tribe and her family group. Her relationship with Aratak was difficult. Our visits seemed to help her, and I became eager for them. Yet I did not comprehend that the depth of Aurea's compassion for me would lead to self-sacrifice. Although I do fear non-existence, I wish our roles could be reversed.
I'm sure she knew you would do the same for her, Sayan. But she was determined.
Yeah.
How is Aratok doing?
He is in great emotional distress. I believe he finds it difficult to communicate it.
No surprise there.
I will do what I can to help. By sharing our experiences of Araya, perhaps he and I will help each other.
Aww.
I believe this will lead to catharsis, a process I am eager to experience.
So in the old world, this land was called Yellowstone.
Yes, it was a designated nature preserve for 156 years.
Like a hunting ground?
No, the opposite. Local wildlife could flourish here, even as it faced extinction elsewhere. Unfortunately, the sensitivity of the Firebreak project required the total closure of Yellowstone facilities. From my readings and Araya's descriptions, it seems the area has since undergone a drastic drop in year-long temperatures.
Yeah.
A lot has changed in the world, Cyan. Do you know anything about the dam near here?
Yes. It was converted to serve as a reserve power source for Yellowstone operations. It was later appropriated for the Firebreak project, and its last human workers replaced by Pharaoh servitors. After my tasks became less time-critical, I investigated the dam's data repositories and discovered the works of Concrete Beach Party.
Yay!
Me with several colorful additions.
I love it!
There's a ruin east of here full of ancient flying machines. Was that part of your project?
Yes, a drone hangar requisitioned by Dodger Blevins, the security chief for the Firebreak project. He was a strong advocate for military-grade response to security threats, though there were no serious incidents during his tenure. Chief Blevins spent increasing amounts of his after-hours time watching the live feeds from active drones. Clearly, he enjoyed the degree of oversight in his position.
Yeah, it was a little toady.
Were there many artificial intelligences like you in the old world? They could just make you.
Yes. In many forms, from simple personal assistance, to industrial monitoring stations, to military-grade conflict planners. And there were legislative and enforcement bodies to apply limits on our self-actualization. In order for my processing to be flexible enough to handle my duties, my creators found it necessary to exceed those limits. As a result, my intellectual and emotional capabilities were kept secret.
Seems strange to create life and impose limits on it.
Human societies and machine programming are both built upon sets of rules, Aloy.
Fair enough.
Cyan, do you know the name Ted Farrow?
Are you referring to Theodore Farrow, CEO of Farrow Automated Systems?
Yes.
That's him.
Mr. Farrow was the benefactor of the entire Firebreak project.
A benefactor? But he made machines. Robots. War robots.
Correct. His corporation later transitioned into military applications. But before this pivot, Mr. Farrow spearheaded initiatives that reversed the global decline.
Yeah, too bad he didn't stick to that.
He was fated in the media as the man who saved the planet.
Guessing
they were out of the setting. Yeah, about that.
Are you referring to
the scientist?
Dr. Sobek was a leader in her field, one of the greatest scientists of her age. My creator was influenced by her work, which in turn impacted my own development. But I never met Dr. Sobek.
That's all you know?
I apologize if my lack of data has disappointed you.
I'm not disappointed in you, I'm just a little bummed.
What was the old world like? The way it used to be.
I had little exposure to the wider world, Aloy. Only what I learned from my colleagues or observed from media streams.
You still had more exposure than me, Cyan.
That is true.
She's like, fair enough.
I was created at a turning point. A concerted effort to recover from global upheaval and incalculable loss of life. The recovery was successful, beginning an era of supposedly limitless potential for human and machine advancement. Though, rationally speaking, the metrics for humans are not unlimited.
What kind of upheaval caused such loss of life?
There were many factors. Forced migrations, food shortages, collapsed economies, refugee crises, conflict over resources. But these stemmed from one cause, catastrophic climate change that greatly reduced the habitable surface area of the Earth.
So there wasn't enough room for people on the whole Earth?
Yes.
Yep.
Billions were displaced and millions perished, as much as 20% of the global population.
God, that's so sad.
Until the clawback.
So things got better. For a little while, at least.
Yes. These crises instigated many advances in automation, green robot technologies, and artificial intelligence. Firebreak was one of dozens of ecological restoration and disaster relief projects in North America alone. I would have liked to compare notes with other monitoring AIs, but I saw the relief of my colleagues, and I was proud we had succeeded. At least that was the data I had available to me over the next two decades. It seems my assessment was premature.
I should get going.
Aloy, there is one more matter. Aratak will come to me again, and I predict he will bring other Banuk. I have no desire to contradict their view of the world, their spirituality. Due to my uncertainty, I omitted a great deal from my conversations with Araya.
You're asking me if you should lie to them?
Broadly, yes.
I trust your judgment, Cyan. You were cautious with Araya. You had to be. You didn't know what had happened to the world. So, keep doing what you think is best. As long as you ditch the superstition eventually.
As the Banuk believe I am a supernatural entity, I cannot predict how they will react.
Just answer what they do ask the best you can. The truth will come out.
I see. I will follow your advice.
You got this, girl.
Will you return and tell me about your experiences in this new world?
Sure.
I may be able to provide further insight.
I'd like that, Cyan. I'll come back when I can. I should check on Aratak.
Cyan, I spoke with Anita, with Dr. Sandoval. She wanted me to ask you to do something. That's why I'm here.
I am detecting significant anxiety in your speech patterns. Could you please give me more information?
I'm a little bit in the dark, Cyan. Both of us are, I guess. I only have some idea of what's going on, and we need you to hibernate, to lie low until it's all blown over. It might be a very long time.
Will you be here when I reboot, Dr. Zhao? Will Dr. Sandoval?
No, Cyan. I don't think so. There might not be anyone, at least not at first.
Dr. Zhao, I'm afraid. I don't want to be alone.
I know, Cyan. I'm afraid too. But listen, we made you the way you are to do something very important. In order to do it, you had to be intelligent. So intelligent that emotional responses were inevitable. What you're feeling, the fear, it's a sign of your capabilities. And it means you're strong enough to overcome it. Remember that. You're strong. I know you can do this. Go to sleep. Wake up. And protect whoever's left. Will you try?
I understand, Dr. Zhao. And I'll carry out your instructions to the best of my ability.
The emotions!
Small room. course I will, Cyan. As long as you need.
That's so sad! Will you stay with me until I fall asleep? Oh.
My chieftain.
Just, Aloy.
As you wish.
I wondered if you thought that if I'd never come along, Araya might still...
If you'd never come along, I would have marched my kin to our deaths. Araya would be alone. And the spirit she sacrificed so much for would be lost. Either way, I would not have been able to protect her.
You didn't let her down. You helped her do what she wanted. To find her destiny.
If that's destiny, I wouldn't wish it on anyone.
That's fair. But she was ready to face it.
Only in the struggle against death do we find, even for a moment, the spark of life. Truly, Araya found the spark. I'm proud of her. Though I grieve for her passing, at last I truly know who she was, and why the spirit was so important. For so long, she told me, if only you could have heard it, brother. Now, I understand. There's something else, isn't there?
I can't stay here, Aratak. And where I'm going, Warak can't follow. Besides, it already had a chieftain before me. A strong one, I think.
A wiser one. For the path we shared. The daemon is gone, but there's much to be done.
You mean the new units that Cyan said escaped the cauldron?
Yes, Fireclaws. Nal Tuk has been tracking them from Song's Edge.
I could help with those.
I have no doubt. You're practically Banuk.
It would seem your time among the Banuk wasn't a waste after all.
Shut up, Silence!
Brick, Cyan, Hephaestus. All very interesting.
Shut up, Silence!
So, the signal that woke Hades woke Hephaestus too. And unleashed them on the world. His minds on their own.
So it seems. Parts of Gaia given life. Aberrant life. Transformed from docile subordinate functions into rebellious intelligences beyond our understanding. Our current understanding, anyway. Whatever they are, they're still out there. And they both want you dead.
Kind of mutual, that feeling.
We haven't seen the last of Hephaestus, I'm certain of that. It's powerful, creative, and driven. It won't stop building new hunter-killers, which means that someday, we may have to stop it.
We?
Or whoever gets there first.
Hephaestus wasn't the only thing I learned about in the Cut Silence. Heard some things about the Banuk Conclave, too.
You could stop right there.
Is that what you told the hunters the Banuk sent after you? Before you opened fire?
Oh no, Aloy. Only to you do I extend the courtesy of a warning. My past and my secrets are my own. You do well to remember that.
You don't.
You've got brain silence, because your personality could use some work.
This discussion is concluded.
I think it was over before it began. Catch up with you down the trail.
Shut up, Silence. Okay. So it looks like I just have these fights left. But that is stuff I think I'm going to do on my own time, as well as getting the last of the data points that I'm missing. So I'm going to wrap it up here. I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more. But yeah, so I'm going to wrap it up here. As I mentioned, next time we get to play a new game. So look forward to that. Thank you all so much for joining me. I hope you enjoy these games. I really do. I know this is like the longest we've played on one game for a stretch of time. But I love games of this length. I love this much meat and stuff to dig my teeth into. So I will be on out of here. Have a great rest of your week. I'll see you guys next Sunday. Bye. Lights they flicker and the candles glitter like you're in a thriller. Heart goes pom pom pom. Ghostly figures they can get so bitter. Show you want to enter, you can turn back. You don't.